Okay, so good morning, students. Okay, students, so today we will be discussing about the third coordinate system, that is the spherical coordinate system. Okay. Now, similar to the cylindrical coordinate system, the spherical coordinate system is also represented taking the Cartesian coordinate system as reference. Okay. Now, in spherical coordinate system, it is observed that the entire three-dimensional universe is in the form of a sphere. Okay. That is the three-dimensional sphere, okay, or a circle. Three dimensional circle means it is a sphere. So that means you can understand that if it is a sphere, then it will have a radius. Okay, in this coordinate system we will have one radius and two angles. Okay, two separate angles. Now the radius will be different, a little bit different compared to the radius of the radius of the cylindrical coordinate system, because in a cylindrical coordinate system the universe was in the shape of a sphere and the height was along the z axis, okay, and the radius was taken as a straight line parallel to the xy plane, okay. But in this case the radius will be taken from the origin. So suppose, since this spherical coordinate system has to be represented with respect to the Cartesian coordinate system, so first of all we will draw the xyz plane, okay, and the axis of the Cartesian coordinate system. Suppose we have a point P. Now we want to locate it in Cartesian coordinate system, that we know it will have some z axis, x axis and y axis, okay. Now for spherical coordinate system, this particular point P, from this point we will draw a straight line to the origin. So from origin we draw a straight line to the point P. So this length will give you the radius, that is the first coordinate. Okay, first coordinate, that means the first coordinate of representing any point in the spherical coordinate system is using the radius. Okay. Okay, then using this radius we will draw a circle in this way, you can say a vertical circle, because three-dimensional circle is not possible to be represented in a 2D structure, okay, because our means monitor screen, that is your mobile screen or a computer screen, is two-dimensional. So it's not possible to represent it, but in order to represent or present in a representable manner, few considerations have to be taken, or this kind of considerations need to be taken, okay, or you may say that it has to be represented in this manner. So this is the actual way of representing the spherical coordinate system. So this is the Cartesian coordinate axis, point P is over here. We will draw a straight line, okay, a straight line, okay. This is the radius R. From this radius we will draw a circle, okay. So we will draw a circle along the z axis, or towards z axis. We will draw a circle towards z axis, okay, or you can say away from the z axis. We will draw a circle away from the z axis like this. We will draw a circle away from the z axis, okay. Now this angle which the point P is making with respect to the z axis is called point theta. That means this is another angle where it is told that what is the angle the point P is away from the z axis, that is theta point, or theta degrees or radians. So theta is the second coordinate. That means the first coordinate is radius r. Then there is a that means point P is having, that means if you want to draw a sphere with point P and represent that point P is on the surface of the sphere, so you will just draw a line from the origin to measure the radius of the sphere first. So radius is the first coordinate. Then you will draw a circle, okay, along this particular away from the z axis in this direction, okay. And you will measure that what angle that point P is making with respect to z axis. That is the coordinate, second coordinate, that is the angle theta. Okay. Now the third coordinate is similar to the cylindrical coordinate system, where this particular circle which you have measured, what is the angle from the x-axis? That means what is the angle of this plane from the x-axis? That means you have drawn a circle like this. Okay, you have drawn a circle like this in this way. Okay, so if I draw a plane like this, so this is intersecting somewhere. Okay. It is intersecting somewhere. So this particular line will be drawn from here to measure what is the angle, because the circle will be along this direction also. Why? Because just imagine that if you are drawing a sphere, first of all you have to draw a circle. Okay. Rather if I show you in this way, you have to draw a circle. Okay. Then another circle like this. Okay. Okay. So that means this first one, or you can say if I represent in a different color, second circle. Okay. Or kind of a oval shape like this. So oval, why? Because it is observe that this oval, that this particular blue circle is being observed from the top and the red circle is observed from the front. Okay, it is observed from the front. So that means if you take a ball which is round, which is a sphere, it appears to be circular from top and from front and back, and also from top and bottom. Okay. So if you take a ball in your hand, then you will be able to understand three-dimensionally that it is a ball. But if you want to draw the picture of a ball on a particular computer, or if you take a picture of a ball in a mobile, you will see it looks like a circle, because you cannot represent a three-dimensional system in a two-dimensional screen, because a ball appears to be a circle, isn't it? So that is why, if it is not a circle, that means if it is a sphere, then it has to be circular in all directions. So in this case, we will represent it circular in two directions, one from the top, one from the side, front, okay, front or side, whatever. So blue is the circular from the top. That is why if you see this particular picture, this circle which is drawn over here with this line, or if I go to this once again, okay, so this red one appears to be the circle from the which is appearing circle circular from the front, and the blue one appears to be circular from the top. That is why the front circle is drawn by this angle theta and top circle is drawn by this angle phi. Okay, you have to draw an angle. Now we will suppose, that means you are drawing a circle like this, a sphere like this, two-dimensionally we are representing. So we are drawing two circles, one from the top, one from the side. Now if you are representing the if you are drawing the Cartesian coordinate system like this, okay, xyz plane for reference, this is x, sorry, this is z, this is x, this is y. Okay. Now there is a point P. There's a point P. Now that point P will have a radius, okay, R. It is making an angle theta. Okay. If I extend it over here, wait. There's a point P on this surface. Okay. So we are drawing a straight line like this. So it is a radius. Now this red circle is three. It is a circular figure. So it is a circle that is 360 degree. But the point P is theta angle from the z axis. So we have to locate at which point is there. If it is it over here or here or here? So how can we locate it? We have to locate from the angle, the angle which it makes with respect to the z axis. You have to locate from that angle. Okay. Because that is required. So if point B is over here, so we will measure what is the angle of this radius of the length which is making with respect to the z axis. Now what is the, now if you see the blue circle, so that means if you see from the top, now from the front you are able to see, okay, from z axis it is making an angle P, so I can identify at what point it is from z axis, because we always represent generally by default every point is represented or every vector is represented in Cartesian coordinate system, that is rectangular coordinate system. But if you want to represent this spherical or cylindrical, we can convert it, you can transform it, okay, or we can directly represent in spherical or cylindrical also. So suppose if you want to transform from Cartesian to spherical, so suppose you know the spherical coordinate axis, okay, you have taken as reference. If you have a point and you want to locate it in spherical system, so first of all you will draw this radius and angle. So from top, from the front, you can see that if there is the red circle is there, then I can easily point this locate this particular point over here. Okay, so it is making an angle theta with the z axis. If you see the ball from the top, that means the point P is on the ball. And if you see from the top, you will not be able to understand that from the top where it is actually located, with which axis it is related to, whether it is related to x axis or y axis or z axis. So for that reason, if you see from the top, you will see the ball as a circular from the top. That means you will see the ball in the form of a red, the blue circle. From blue circle, how to locate it? You will draw a dotted line and place that line on the this particular xy plane, okay, and you will draw this line. You will get an angle that is phi angle. This phi angle is similar to what you have seen in cylindrical coordinate system, because in cylindrical coordinate system you have this cylinder like this, okay, and you had this Cartesian coordinate system. So you had the radius, suppose this is a point, you have the area of the radius like this, okay, and you have this phi angle, okay, you have this phi angle. So here also same thing, here the phi angle will be for this particular plane, for this particular plane. So phi angle, phi axis is similar to the cylindrical, so this is common. So unit vector will be like this. This is a unit vector. Okay. So three coordinates we have got: r, phi, r theta, and phi. Three coordinates we have got. So the spherical coordinate system represents the entire 3D dimension in the form of a sphere, and it has three coordinates. One is radius, and one is an angle with respect to z axis, and the third is another angle with respect to the x axis. Okay, then only you can locate a point in the spherical coordinate system. Okay, so the points are r, theta, and q, phi. Okay, so r is the distance from the origin of P, theta has a name which is called the collatitude, is the angle between the z axis and the position of the position vector of P. Phi is measured in the x-axis, which is same as the azimuthal angle in spherical in cylindrical coordinate system. It will be cylindrical. The same angle in cylindrical coordinates. Okay. So according to these definitions, the range of variables will be. So what are the ranges then? Obviously, the radius can be 0 to infinity. Okay. Theta is taken as 0 to pi. It is not taken as 2 pi theta. Why? Because this is for reference. Because any point, because if you are taking this phi as 0 to 2 pi, then if you take theta from 0 to pi, that will be sufficient. Otherwise, if you take both as 0 to 2 pi, then it will be confusing at which particular point this is actually located. Okay. So if it is located like this, okay, so it may be confusing if you take the both angles from 0 to 2 pi. So if it is taken like this, if you take the phi as this angle, okay, and if you take the theta, okay, theta also as positive, then it will be, it won't create a problem in calculation. Okay, in calculation it won't create a problem, because there will be a problem in sine also. Okay, so that is why it is avoided. So that is the reason why theta is taken as 0 to pi and phi as 0 to 2 pi. Okay, that will be it will be explained to you when you perform the transformation part. Okay, so is it clear to you, the three coordinates r, theta and pi? Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so is it clear? Did you understand the basics of the spherical coordinate system? Yes or no? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Are you sure? Okay, now once we have discussed about the locating a point in the spherical coordinate system, now we have to locate a vector also in spherical coordinate system. So vector also has to be represented. Okay, so you need to represent a vector. So for representing a vector, it is similar to the other two coordinate systems. So here also the vector is represented like this. Okay, just like ax unit vector x plus ay unit vector y plus az unit vector z, and also in cylindrical you have seen a rho unit vector rho plus a phi unit vector phi and az unit vector z. In spherical it will be ar unit vector r, a theta unit vector theta, a phi unit vector phi. Now phi is common, but the orientation has been changed. Because in spherical, in Cartesian coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system, both had z axis as common axis. Both had z axis, but z orientation was at the third point, third position. But here, in cylindrical and spherical, the phi axis is common. Both have phi axis, but their orientation are different because their consideration are a little bit different with respect to each other. Okay, that is why. In cylindrical coordinate system, the phi axis was taken as the second position and second axis, but in spherical we have taken phi as the third axis. But both phi will be common. So if you want to transfer from cylindrical to spherical, you don't have to change anything for phi. It will be common for both. Okay. Now once you have to represent a vector, so if you need to represent any vector in a coordinate system, you have to know the unit vectors, and again transformation will be there from spherical to cylindrical to Cartesian, whatever. So we will talk about that later on. First of all, we have to know that the unit vectors of the spherical coordinate system, how they are represented. First of all, if you observe this figure carefully, okay, I take this figure over here, if you see this particular figure for this spherical coordinate system, observe carefully. Okay, so now this, first of all, we have this r radius. So radius is obviously, when it is drawn, it is started from the origin 0 and then it is connected to the point P, so it is going upwards. So the unit vector of r is upwards in this direction. Okay, now we have the angle theta. Now angle theta is measured from the z axis. Obviously we will measure from the reference. If you are measuring any angle, you draw two lines and you measure the angle with respect to the reference. So reference is 0, this is 0 degree and this is theta degree. So theta degree means with respect to the radius, so it is traveling in this direction. Unit vector is traveling in this direction, a theta. And phi angle is same as you have seen in cylindrical coordinate system. So it will be perpendicular to this particular plane. Perpendicular to this plane. This plane is there. So it is perpendicular to this particular plane. Okay. That is a phi. So AR, A phi, okay, and A theta. So AR, A phi, and A theta. All are perpendicular with respect to each other. They all are orthogonal with respect to each other. Okay. So these are the axis. Now obviously if you want to locate any vector, if there is a vector like this, there is a vector, okay, A, so it will be represented in this way. Okay. It is very similar to Cartesian and spherical. Okay. So I think you can understand that if you know the unit vectors a r, a theta, and a rho, a phi, okay, and you know the values of a r because these coordinates will also be given to you, you should also be known, then you can easily represent it. So it is known because you have already studied the other two coordinate systems, so it is known to you. The procedure is same. Okay, now the magnitude is calculated similarly for the other two coordinate system because the equations, the concept of vector will not change. So if you want to find the magnitude of the vector, okay, so if you know the coordinates, then the square root of summation of the first square, the square root of the first coordinate, square of first coordinate plus square of second coordinate plus square of third coordinate, it is AR square plus A theta square plus A phi square. Okay, this will be phi. There is a printing mistake. This is phi. Okay. So these are the common equations of vectors. Now once again, if the vector, the unit vectors are known to you, then obviously you can also determine the dot product and cross product between the unit vectors, the different axis vectors. So obviously if you take the dot product of a unit vector with itself, it will be 1, it is known to you. And if you take the dot product with a unit vector with any other vector, it will be 0 because the angle is 90 degree. The same, because what we have seen for ax dot ay, it is 0, and a rho dot a phi, if it is 0, obviously for ar dot a theta, it will also be 0. Same for all the coordinate systems. And if you take the cross product of any two vectors, you will get the third product, third vector, because this is r, this is phi. If you take the cross product, so the resultant will be perpendicular. Okay, because the third vector is the perpendicular vector, so So obviously the resultant will be a perpendicular vector. This is known to you. It's similar to Cartesian and cylindrical. Now once again, this differential length, area and volume concept will also be there. Okay, so you have to summarize in this way that whenever you are studying this coordinate system chapter, first of all you will see that you will come across Cartesian coordinate system. Over there you will be studying about how to represent a point in a Cartesian coordinate system, number one. Number two, how to represent a vector in the Cartesian coordinate system, and what are the relationship between the axis of the different unit vectors, that you have to understand. If you understand that thing, then you can understand the same concept for this spherical and cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, and one more thing will be there. If you study the cylindrical and spherical coordinate system, you have to study the transformation, that is transformation between any axis, any coordinate system, that means Cartesian to spherical, spherical to cylindrical, cylindrical to spherical, cylindrical to Cartesian, everything, every combination is there. Okay, now one more part is there, that you have to study the differential length, area and volume. So you have studied differential length, area and volume, number one, for Cartesian coordinate system, and you have also studied the same concept for cylindrical coordinate system. Similarly, there will be the same study for the differential length, area and volume for spherical coordinate system also. Okay, so you can see here you are familiar with this particular equations. It is very similar to what you have seen for the other two coordinate systems. Here also you will be studying the same thing. So for that, you see, I think I don't have to repeat, because all of you know that how you have to proceed. So what is this actually? This is actually showing a particular section of a sphere. Why? Because previously what we have done, we have taken a point P and a point Q, and we have traveled along the path along the coordinates from point P to Q. Okay. Here also we will do the same thing. Okay. Suppose this point is point P. This is point P. Okay. If you are unable to understand, or if you think that I am going too fast, then you can interrupt me anytime. Okay. Okay, so we have point P over here and point Q somewhere else. Now it is being observed that point Q is away from point P in such a way that in all the three axes you have to travel by some distance. You have to increase the radius, you have to increase the angle theta, and you have to increase the angle phi. Okay, so if the radius of point P is, suppose, R, this is R, then the radius of point Q, this point, is R plus dr, that means some radius more, dr plus. So this is r plus dr, so this one will also be r plus dr, come from 0 to this point. So this point is also dr. Okay, you have to travel along dr first. That means first you have to travel along the radius, you have to increase the radius. Then the angle for theta, so that is the angle which point P is making with respect to Z axis, is theta. This angle is theta. Point P, which is there, it is making angle theta with respect to Z axis. But point Q is not making angle theta, it is making an angle theta plus d theta. Okay, so theta plus d theta, so this is d theta, this angle. So you have to travel along this path. This path, d theta. Now the angle which point P is making with respect to x axis is phi, but point Q is making an angle phi plus d phi. So this is d phi, this angle is d phi. Okay, so you have to travel along this d phi also. Then you will reach Q. That means you are traveling like this, radius, theta and then phi. we are traveling dr, d theta and d phi. Then you are reaching point Q from P to Q. So what is the incremental length? Incremental length will not be as it is observed because the first...
Hello sir.
Yes.
So point Q same sphere pe hai jo P pe hai.
दोनों
अलग
अलग स्पीयर पे है, मुझे पता है ये थोड़ा ये क्वेश्चन अगर किए हो मतलब कि तुम समझ रहे हो, दिस इज गुड. सो द थिंग इज दैट इन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम इफ आई रिप्रेजेंट वेट कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम में क्या था, कार्टेशियन में था कि तुम्हारा एक्सिस था ऐसा, ठीक है एक्सिस था, तो ये एक्सिस ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है, मतलब कोई पॉइंट अगर है यहाँ पे, यहाँ पर कोई पॉइंट है, मतलब कि रेक्टेंगुलर कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम मतलब क्या है, इसको हम रेक्टेंगल की तरह ट्रीट करेंगे, है ना, रेक्टेंगल की तरह ट्रीट करेंगे इसको. रेक्टेंगल और अ क्यूब लाइक दिस, तो कोई पॉइंट पी अगर यहां पर है तो उसका हाइट है ये वाला, अगर कोई पॉइंट क्यू यहां पर है इस पोजिशन पे है तो वो तो इस हाइट में नहीं रहेगा, इस क्यूब में नहीं रहेगा, तो उसके लिए अलग से क्यूब बनाना पड़ेगा, बड़ा वाला क्यूब बनाना पड़ेगा उसके लिए, बड़ा वाला क्यूब. ठीक है, अगर कोई पॉइंट मान लो के एस है, एस एस जो ऐसा है, तो उसके लिए और भी बड़ा क्यूब बनाना पड़ेगा. दैट मीन्स द साइज ऑफ द क्यूब इज नॉट फिक्स्ड और रेक्टेंगल इज नॉट फिक्स्ड बिकॉज इन रेक्टेंगुलर कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड द कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, ओके दैट कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम tells you that any point in the universe is represented in the form of a cube or a rectangle, rectangle or you can say cuboidal, जो भी होता है, ऐसे represent करेंगे हम लोग. Spherical में क्या होता है, spherical में spherical में स्फेरिकल को समझने के लिए हमको फिर से वो ठीक है कार्टेशियन को रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे हम लोग पहले. ठीक है, तो मान लो कि पॉइंट पी है यहाँ पे, ठीक है हम कार्टेशियन को रिप्रेजेंट नहीं करते बाद में करेंगे, मान लो कि पॉइंट पी है, तो पी जो है पी के लिए हम लोग एक सर्कल ड्रॉ करेंगे, स्पीयर ड्रॉ करेंगे, थ्री डायमेंशनल स्पीयर. मान लो कि ये एक बॉल है, अगर पॉइंट क्यू यहाँ पर है उसके लिए एक बड़ा वाला स्पीयर ड्रॉ करेंगे, और पॉइंट एस है अंदर है तो उसके लिए छोटा वाला स्पीयर ड्रॉ करेंगे. तो मतलब कि कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम अगर हम लोग इस्तेमाल करेंगे उसको एक्सप्लेन करने के लिए, तो यहाँ पर देखेंगे कि जो छोटा वाला है उसका रेडियस है आर, पी जो है उसका रेडियस है आर टू, ये है आर वन, ठीक है, और Q जो है उसका रेडियस है आर थ्री, इसका एंगल है थीटा वन थीटा वन, इसका एंगल है थीटा टू, इसका एंगल है थीटा थ्री, अलग अलग है. ठीक है, अब इसको आप जब प्रोजेक्ट करेंगे नीचे तो ये वाला एंगल जो है ये फाइव वन है, इसको जब प्रोजेक्ट करेंगे नीचे मान लो यहाँ पर आया ये, तो इसका जो एंगल है ये अलग होगा, मान लो कि ये कम है थोड़ा, फाइव टू है, और सॉरी ये रेड से होता तो अच्छा होता, एक मिनट कौन सा वाला, सॉरी ये वाला ना, ये वाला, सॉरी ये वाला, हाँ तो ये वाला मान लो इसका एंगल ऐसा है थीटा टू है, और ये जो है इसका एंगल बहुत ज्यादा है मान लो कि, ठीक है दैट मीन्स इट इज नॉट अ वन सर्कल, एवरी पॉइंट कितने भी पॉइंट हो हमारे पास, कोई भी पॉइंट अगर लिया, पॉइंट W लिया उसका भी उसके लिए एक स्पीयर ड्रॉ करेंगे, पॉइंट T लिया उसके लिए भी स्पीयर ड्रॉ करेंगे, पॉइंट Z लिया उसके भी स्पीयर ड्रॉ करेंगे. दैट मीन्स एवरी पॉइंट इज कॉन्सिडर दैट देर इज अ पॉइंट P, सो दैट पॉइंट P वी विल टेक अ रेडियस फ्रॉम द ओरिजिन एंड देन वी ड्रॉ अ सर्कल सच दैट दैट पॉइंट P इज ऑन द सर्फेस. क्योंकि अगर रेडियस लेंगे और सर्कल ड्रॉ करेंगे तो ऑब्वियसली वो पॉइंट जो था वो सर्फेस पे होगा, बीच में अंदर नहीं होगा, ठीक है ना. तो यहाँ पर वही दिखा रहे हैं हम लोग कि स्पीयर एक नहीं है, कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम एक है. जैसे कि इस वाले में था अलग अलग रेक्टेंगल है, लेकिन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम को रेफरेंस एक है, कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम एक ही है, रेक्टेंगल अलग अलग है, ठीक है जी. मतलब कि फर्स्ट फ्लोर, सेकंड फ्लोर, थर्ड फ्लोर ऐसे जा रहा है. ये वाला भी सेम है, एक है टेनिस बॉल, एक है फुटबॉल, मतलब एक है टेबल टेनिस बॉल, एक है क्रिकेट बॉल, एक है फुटबॉल, ऐसा है. दैट मीन्स द रेडियस विल चेंज, एंगल विल चेंज, एवरीथिंग विल चेंज, बट इट विल बी इन अ स्पीयर. दैट मीन्स इट इज विद इन द यूनिवर्स विच इज द शेप ऑफ अ स्पीयर. जैसे कि हम लोग धरती पे है, ठीक है, तो एक ही स्पीयर, एक ही साइज का स्पीयर है ना, एक ही स्पीयर है, ऐसा नहीं है, अलग अलग स्पीयर हो सकता है, ठीक है. मतलब कि अगर इफ यू आर स्टडिंग योर स्कूल दैट अर्थ का जो धरती का जो एकदम बीच वाला हिस्सा है उसको इंग्लिश में कहते हैं कोर, फिर आता है मेंटल, फिर आता है क्रस्ट, ठीक है, ऐसा ना. तो फिर मतलब कि जो धरती का ग्राउंड होता है उसको क्रस्ट कहते हैं. उसका ऊपर जो अगर वो जो ये इसको देखेंगे, एटमोसफेयर को देखेंगे, एटमोसफेयर को भी एक स्पीयर की तरह ड्रॉ करते हैं हम लोग, वो बड़ा वाला स्पीयर है, ठीक है, जिसके अंदर हवा है, और उसके ऊपर जो स्पीयर है उसके ऊपर हम लोग स्पेस में जा सकते हैं, और ग्रेविटी कितना तक है उसका भी अलग एक स्पीयर है, और सैटेलाइट जो फ्लो करता है वो भी अलग एक स्पीयर है ना. होता है कि नहीं होता है?
यस सर.
हाँ, सो मान लो कि ये वाला, ये मान लो कि कोर है, ठीक है, इसमें फायर है, ठीक है, ऐसे एक्सप्लेन कर रहा हूँ मैं. फिर आया तुम्हारा मेंटल, ये तो स्कूल में पढ़े थे तुम लोग, ठीक है. फिर आया क्रस्ट, ठीक है. फिर आया एटमॉस्फेयर, एटमॉस्फेयर के बाद आएगा, एटमॉस्फेयर आएगा, फिर स्पेस आएगा. मतलब कि देर आर डिफरेंट स्पीयर्स बट इट इज टेकन विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू दी वन कॉमन एक्सिस, वन कॉमन एक्सिस विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू दी कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम एक्स वाई जेड प्लेन. तो मान लो ये वाला जो है, ये वाला अगर पॉइंट यहाँ पर है, इसका रेडियस अलग होगा, इसका अलग अलग होगा, इसका अलग होगा, इसका अलग होगा, ठीक है, तो ऐसा ही है. दैट मीन्स वेन एवर देर इज अ पॉइंट पी, ये जो पहला वाला था पॉइंट पी था, पॉइंट पी था, तो इस पॉइंट पी को लेके हम लोग एक सर्कल ड्रॉ करेंगे, रेडियस आर होगा, थीटा एंगल पे सर्कल ड्रॉ करेंगे. पॉइंट की जो है, क्यू जो है, उसका रेडियस है, दैट रेडियस इज आर प्लस डी आर एंड एंगल इज थीटा प्लस डी थीटा. तो उसके लिए अलग से एक सर्कल ड्रॉ करेंगे. तो एक सर्कल से दूसरे सर्कल में अब जाना है, अगर मतलब कि ये वाला सर्कल, ये थोड़ा क्लमजी हो गया, इसमें दिखाते हैं, ये वाला सर्कल है, यहां से यहां तक जाएंगे तो कैसे जाएंगे, ऐसे जाएंगे, फिर ऐसे जाएंगे, ठीक है. फाइव ड्रॉक नहीं किया है क्योंकि टू डायमेंशनल हम ऐसे जाएंगे, अगर थ्री डायमेंशनल हो तो फाइव भी एक एंगल आता था, ऐसा आता था, ऐसा होता, ऐसा होता. ये पॉइंट पी है, ये पॉइंट क्यू है, ये अलग सा सर्कल है, ये अलग सा सर्कल है, ठीक है. सो दैट मीन्स इट इज नॉट अ सिंगल सर्कल और अ सिंगल स्पीयर. सो विथ पॉइंट पी आर ड्रॉइंग अ स्पीयर, क्यू वी आर ड्रॉइंग अ स्पीयर. सो फ्रॉम पी टू क्यू हैव टू ट्रेवल इन दिस वे, हैव टू इंक्रीज रेडियस, वो वाले स्पीयर में चले गए. फिर मतलब कि पहले वाला स्पीयर जो था वो पी के रेडियस के हिसाब से था, क्यू वाला जो था वो थोड़ा बड़ा सर्कल था, तो हम लोग पहले वो बड़ा सर्कल पे हम लोग पहुंचेंगे, उस हिसाब से हम पहुंच गए. फिर कौन से लोकेशन पे क्यू है वो हमको देखना है, तो हम लोग थीटा थीटा जाएंगे, इसके पैरेलल नजदीक आ गए, पैरेलल आ गए, पैरेलल लाइन पे आ गए, फिर हम लोग लास्ट पे फाई को बढ़ा के वहां पर पहुंच जाएंगे. सो फर्स्ट रेडियस, देन दैट मीन्स वी आर रीचिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर लेंथ ऑफ द स्पीयर, रेडियस ऑफ द स्पीयर, देन वी विल कम नेक्स्ट टू इट, पैरेलल टू इट, देन वी विल रीच क्यू फाइनली. सो इन दिस वे यू हैव टू डू इट. ओके, ठीक है. तो आज के लिए इतना ही है, क्योंकि फिर जो आर्क रहेगा वो हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्लास में डिस्कस करेंगे, फिर कन्वर्शन आएगा, ये वाला हम नेक्स्ट क्लास में डिस्कस. हाँ बोलो.
फाई एंगल को भी तो वर्टिकली फिर बढ़ाना होगा.
फाई एंगल को वर्टिकली, हाँ, ये फाई है ना, ये वाला, ये जो फाई था, अब जो क्यू में आगे, क्यू जो है वो क्यू फाई एंगल नहीं है, फाई से ज्यादा है, वो है फाई प्लस डी फाई. तो ये जो इंक्रीज हुआ है ये डी फाई है, लेकिन ये एग्जैक्टली डी फाई नहीं है, क्योंकि डी फाई एंगल है, इंक्रीज हुआ है आर्क, है ना, जैसे सिलिंड्रिकल में देखा था आर्क इंक्रीज हुआ है, इसलिए हम लोग इसको डी फाई नहीं लेंगे, इसको लेंगे हम आर डी फाई, जैसे आर डी थीटा. ठीक है, ये अगर डी थीटा है तो ये वाला जो हिस्सा है, ये वाला डी थीटा नहीं होगा, ये वाला होगा आर डी थीटा. ओके, ऐसा तो वो हम लोग देखेंगे कैसा कैसा होता है, दैट वी विल आई विल एक्सप्लेन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. ठीक है, तो ये आता समझ में आया ना कि अलग अलग स्पीयर होगा, ये कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर है ना?
हाँ सर.
ओके ओके ओके, देन वी कैन कंक्लूड आवर लेक्चर फॉर टुडे ओवर अप टू हियर. ओके, सो लेट मी टेक दिस स्नैपशॉट ऑफ द अटेंडेंस. ओके, सो थैंक यू देन.